Alright guys, so let's try and finish this off. Let's try and finish the main mirror here off in this part, and let's do this last piece here in the final part so that we can move on to something else. Alright, so to continue this, what we're going to do now is to get over to this side. Let's see. We already have a supporting edge loop going on over there, so we don't need anything else. Now all that we have to do is to solidify this. So before we actually do that, let me see, let's add in one supporting edge loop down here. I'm going to press Ctrl and R2 here, press E, and then let's move that down as close as the one on this side. I'm going to do the same thing here. Alright, so if I press Ctrl and R, you can see it goes all the way through, but it extends down here. It extends all the way down here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this one, I'm going to hide it. Let's press Ctrl and R, press E and F, align it with the top, and pull it in close like that. Now press Alt and H, and what we're going to do is we're going to knife this from here all the way to there, like that. And press Enter. Now take this and then take that, press Alt and M, and choose At Last. Alright, so that should be looking good. Alright. So all I'm going to do now is to solidify this on the rims. Alright, so let me see. I think that's pretty much everything so far. You can see we have some stripes here, but I'm not going to bother and do that, because if I try doing that, I think we might encounter some problem. And this series might actually, this particular mirror making might actually take too long. So let's just leave it as is. Let's keep things the way they are. So let's add in the solidify now. So we're going to add in, I think we have supporting edge loops everywhere. Yeah. So let's add in the solidify. So we're going to, first of all, let's fill this area, okay? So the reason why I'm saying we should fill this area is because we're going to be applying the solidify as a rim. And what that means is it's going to apply the solidify only to places that are open, like this side. And since this side is also open, if we don't fill it up, since we don't need any extra edge loops in here, it might actually add in an extra one once we apply the solidify, which we don't want. So we're going to fill this area like this, just so the solidify doesn't affect it. But we'll delete it later once we finish applying the solidify. So let's add in the solidify now. Just minimize this. Sorry. So let's add in the solidify modifier like that. And you can see it's looking great already. So good. Let's drop this down to 0.005. Let's see how that looks. Nice. Let's drop it down to 0.002. Is that still too thick? Okay, let's take it to 0.004. No, 0.003. 0.003 should be good. So we'll leave it at 0.003 and let's enable only rim. So you can see what I mean. Only rim applies the solidify only to the edges, like that, as you're seeing. Now we've added in the solidify with the only rim enabled right there. So what we're going to do now is to apply the solidify. So click on apply like that, and it applies the solidify, but as you can see, it goes away. Now the only reason that is happening is because it is assigning these extra edge loops that we have here. It is adding them to the vertex group that we added in. Okay, so we're going to go to the vertex group here and we're going to remove it out of it, and that should give us what we had initially, like that. So let's go back in here, or let's just add in the next solidify now. Let's go back up here and let's add in the next solidify. I don't know if we even need that. I don't think we do. Do we? Okay, maybe we do. I don't know. Okay, let's add it in. Sorry. Let's add in the next solidify. Press point. Let's type in 0.00, was it 3, I think? 0.003. Yeah, I think it was 0.003. Now, enable only rim, just like we did with the other one. Let's keep it there like that. And let's apply this. So apply it, and let's get over here. You can see we have some problems here. Let's fix them up real quick. So I want to slide this all the way here. Take this, slide it all the way up here. Slide this here, and slide it here. Now this one next, slide it down here, Just going to wireframe, take this, slide it back here, take this, slide it here, very nice. So let me see, I think we might actually have the same problem here, yeah. Let's zoom in, slide this up, take this, slide it back, sorry, slide this up and slide this forward. Now let's do the same thing here, slide this back here, go into wireframe, take this, slide this down. Slide this down and slide this down. Alright, so that looks great. Now all that I'm gonna do now is to, let me see, if I take these edge loops, the very ones at the end here, and let me try removing them. So let's remove them and see what happens. Yeah, so it gives us that nice bevel that I was looking for. That was what I was looking to go for, like that. So first off, before we actually remove them, here's what we're gonna do. Let's assign them again. Alright, let's add one in the middle of each, one over here and one over here, and I'm gonna take them again. I'm gonna take those edges again. You can see the edges I'm talking about. So let's just take them and let's remove them from it like that. I don't know if that worked. Let's dissolve the ones in the middle. So dissolve it. Let's dissolve this one as well. Alright, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to add in another one over here. So press E, and then align it with the right side and pull it in like that. Very nice. We're going to do the same thing with the one on the bottom. Press E, and then F, align it with the right side, and pull it close in like that. Alright, so that should look good. As you can see, it's looking really, really great. Now, all that we're going to do now is to finish off this one as well. Very nice. So let's go into edit mode, and how are we going to finish this one off? Okay, so this whole piece is one full plastic, so the separation here is irrelevant. So let's take these two, press Alt and M, merge it at last. Let's take these two here as well, Alt and M, merge it at last. Let's take these two, let me zoom in right there. Take these two, Alt M at last, and finally these two, Alt M at center, or at last, or at first, whichever one. So now you can see it's one piece now. So all we're going to do is, let's add in a solidify, alright? So let's add in a solidify modifier. So add in a solidify modifier like that. And we have to drop down the thickness. As you can see, it's too much. But before we actually do that, let's add in extra edge loops in the middle here. So I'm going to press Ctrl and R, add in two, and leave it there like that. Alright, very nice. So let's just make sure this face here is flat. So I'm going to press F, and then let's change the pivoting point to boundary box, and let's change the orientation to normal. Let's press S and Z and type in 0, alright, just to flatten everything like that. Now delete the faces. Let's take this, let's dissolve it, let's dissolve this, let's add them in again, two of them, like that. Alright. So that is looking great. It's looking okay. Let me take a look at this side. Oh, this one came all the way to this side. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to try to fix that. That edge loop that we added in didn't go all the way up here. So you can see it's not helping this side at all. So we have to add that in to help this side. But first, let's take this and delete the faces, because we're done with that. And I'm going to take all of these from here to the center here. You can see the ones I've selected. And I'm going to press X and dissolve the edges. So what I'm going to do now is to press Ctrl and R through here. Let me hide. I'm going to wireframe. Let's put up the shrink wrap, okay, so we can see things much better. I'm going to take this and hide it. I'm going to press Ctrl and R through here, press E and then F. And align it with that side, press Alt and H to bring everything back. And let me press Ctrl and R through here as well. Bring it close to this side. G twice, press E. And let's bring it close to it like that. I want to take this and then now press Alt and M and choose at last. Alright, so we're going to move down here now. Let me see. Yeah, right here. I want to take these two and press J. I want to take this and that and this one. Press Alt and M and choose at last. Alright, so that should sharpen that area very nicely for us, as you can see. What is wrong with this one? Why is it pulled up so much? have no clue why. Let me see. You can see it's going beyond it for some reason, I don't know. Let's just put up the solidify. I'm going to try and find out why that is happening. Or we could just fix it by sliding things around. So let me just get into back view real quick. And wow, it's pretty big of a gap because it's on all these sides here, all the way to the bottom, and on this side as well. I don't even have a shrink wrap going on. Did we disable it? No, it's on. So what is going on? Let's remove the group and let's see. Let me see. Oh, okay, I see what the problem is. We have the shrink wrap disabled on this one, so let's just enable it to bring it back to that. Alright, very nice. Let me take a look at this. This side has a bit of a problem because it doesn't have enough. So let's just put one in the middle here, like that. And let's put one in the middle here as well, just to, you know, equalize everything. And let's go here, let's take all of these, the edge of the one we just added in, and let's pull it forward a little bit like that. So we're just gonna have to, okay, let's keep things like that. And let's enable the solidify now. Let's see what we have. Alright, it's pretty good. It's quite good. Now, let me take everything. What I want to do now is to move it in the y-axis. So let's change the pivoting point back to, the orientation back to global. And I'm going to move this in the y-axis, pull it in close, like that. You can see that is looking great. We have a bit of a problem here. Let me try fixing that. Let me take all of these. I'm going to move it in the y-axis. Pull it out. Let me pull it in a little bit more. I'm going to pull one in the middle here because we need it. I'm going to pull it in the z-axis. Like that. And let me see. Let me take all of these. Let's pull it in a Y. Let's see what we have. Pull it in a Y. Let's go in here as well. Take all of these. Let's pull it in a Y as well, like that. Alright, so I think that is looking quite good. Yeah, it's looking quite good. That's exactly what we're going for. So it's looking like the mirror now. So what we're going to do now is to try and get this side right. What I want to do is, first of all, let's take this. I think I should fill this side myself manually. So I'm going to press F. And I'm going to press I to insert the face like that. And then I again to insert it again like that. Press X and delete the faces. Alright. So we're going to change the solidify method to only rim now. So let's just put it on only the rims. And let's fill this area for now. Let me see. Let's hide these real quick. Let's go over here. So we're going to take this one, okay, and then that one. And let me see. Let's load back in the group. And let's remove these from the group like that. Alright, so that is looking great. Let me take these again, just to be sure again. I'm going to press F, and I want to change the orientation to normal. I'm going to press S, N, and Z and type in 0, just to flatten it again. Let me see. Like that. Let me go over to the top view, and let's see what we have. Alright, that's good. So when you take all of these, press X and delete the faces. Now I'm going to press Alt and H to bring everything back. Okay, that brought the whole car back. So let's take these two, press Ctrl and I and hide everything else. Alright, this is looking good. Now I'm going to take this piece here. I want to take the whole thing. Let me see. Let's move it in the y-axis. Let's change the orientation back to global. And let's move it in the y-axis back a little bit. And let's take this, move this out to about here. Take this, move this out to there. So you can see how that is looking. Take this, move it out to there. Nice. Let's take this. Let's pull this in to there. Very nice. Take this one, let's pull it into there. Take this, pull it into there. Take this, let's pull it in to there. Let's take this and let's pull it in to there. See what's going on here. Alright. Alright, so this is looking good. It's looking good. I think we got this very nicely. So, you know, let's get rid of the whole solidify thing. Alright, let's go back in here. Let's take all of this. Let's press F. Change the orientation back to normal. Press S and Z and type in 0 to flatten everything. And let's get rid of the ones in the middle. And let's add them back in. Like that. Let's take these and let's press X and delete the faces. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is to take all of this, press F to insert the faces, to fill the faces, press I to insert it a little bit like that, and press X and delete the faces. Take this, and let's remove it from the vertex group. So click on remove. Let's put two in the middle here. Let's remove both of them as well. Let's pull them out just a little bit like that. So you can see what is going on. Very nice. Now I'm going to take this one right here, the innermost one. I'm going to press E and then Y. Okay, hold up. Let's change the orientation back to global. I'm going to press E and then Y. Extrude this back. Like this. E and then Y again. And extrude this back again. Like that. Alright. So that is looking great for me. And I'm hoping you guys had the same result without any problems. Very nice. Now when you're extruding in Blender, you need to be very, very careful in case maybe you extrude something and you want to undo the extrusion. Make sure you press Ctrl Z after you right click to undo the extrusion, because if you don't do that, here's what happens if you don't do that. Okay, so say maybe we have this edge here, right? We're gonna extrude it like we extruded here, and we undoed it and had to enable the distance back to the orientation back to normal before extruding it again. Here's what actually happens. If you press E for the first time and you're like, oh no, I made a mistake, let me undo the extrusion. So you right click, that extrusion is still there, it's not undone. Okay, it's still there, because if you press G, you can see it's still there. So in order to get rid of it, you need to press Ctrl Z again. So now if you press G, you can see it's not there anymore. Alright, so just make sure you do that every time you're modeling, just to avoid that mistake. You don't want to have double vertices in the same place. So yeah, I think that pretty much would kind of do it for this one. But let me take this, let's move it in the y-axis to about here, like that. Now I'm going to take this one, I don't know which one that is. Okay, it's for the same thing. So let's press G twice, let's pull it out like that. It went out. Let's pull it out a little bit more. Like that. Nice. So all that we're going to do now is to take this. Let's go into edit mode. Let's press Ctrl and R through here. Let's move it close to the back. Like that. I'm going to press Shift and D. And press P to separate the selection. Now let's take that one. Go into edit mode. Press A. And press F. To fill the faces like that. And what we're going to do is we're going to delete the subdivision surface from this one. Alright, and also delete the shrink wrap from it like that. Let's pull this down a little bit like that. Alright, this is looking good. Alright, So, you know, let's actually add back in the subdivision surface, because it actually subdivides the site very nicely for us, so we can actually fit this in that area quite good. So let me just select this one. You know, let's delete that whole thing again. Let's take it again. So this is it. Press Shift and D. Press P. Separate the selection. Take it. Take all of them and press F. And it should be in that exact area. So what we're going to do now is to insert the faces just a little bit like that. I'm going to take the outermost one. Press X and delete the vertices. Okay, I think that was too much. So let's undo that. That was too much. Let's put one in the middle. Like that. And let's delete the outermost one. Alright, I think that is way better. That is way, way better. Yeah. So take the whole thing and press Shift and N to recalculate the normals. And let's just enable inside like that to recalculate the normals like that. But just in case yours is already facing the outside, there's no need to click on that inside to change the direction. Alright. So you can see that is looking great. Now all you're gonna do is to add in, let's delete the shrink wrap modifier, alright? And let's see what we can do about this. Let's change this to simple. Oh no, let's keep it at cut more clock. Like that, and let's should I say apply? Let's apply it, alright? Let's go into edit mode. So here's what we have. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select this one right here. Press X and delete the vertices. So you can see we have an extra one out there. Now let's take all of this one by pressing L with the mouse on it. Let's press X and delete the vertices. Now I'm going to take this one and press F to fill the faces like that. So that gets rid of all those extra vertices there and gives us this one. So all that we're going to do now is to insert the face just a little bit like that. Nice. And I'm going to add in a solidify real quick. I'm going to... Yeah, that's too much. So let's drop it down to 0.005, 0.003. Yeah, so 0.003 should be quite good. We'll keep it at 0.003. And yeah, so that should pretty much do it for the actual main mirror. In the next video, what we'll be doing is this this piece here that attaches the mirror to the body. But the main mirror is now finished, as you can see. So all we have to do now is to add in a mirror modifier to each of the objects here so that it can replicate on the other side. So I'm going to do that right now. So let's take this one and let's add in a mirror modifier. So add in a mirror modifier and let's move it all the way up. Let's move the mirror modifier all the way up to here. And let me see. Sorry. Now the... Sorry. The guide meshes, let's disable all of these, okay? All the guide meshes here, let's disable them. You can see what is going on here, we're going to try and fix that. So let's disable all the guide meshes, and let's bring the side mirrors guide. So enable the guide meshes to bring the side mirror guide. So what we're going to do now is to take this, and let's add in a mirror modifier, alright? I'm going to move it above the subdivision surface, and that should fix the problem. Now I'm going to hide that again, guide meshes. So put that off like that. Okay, I think that fixed it very nicely. Alright, so what we're going to do next is to take this, apply the rotation, let's apply the rotation and apply the location just to make sure it's on the perfect, it's mirrored perfectly to the other side. So what we're going to do now is to take this one and do the exact same thing. So add in a mirror modifier. Move it above all the others. Press Ctrl A, rotation, Ctrl A, location. And I think those are the only two pieces. Yeah. Including this one as well. So add in a mirror modifier. Move that up. Ctrl A, location, Ctrl A, rotation. And that should pretty much do it for the whole video. So I'll see you guys in the next video. I'll actually be renaming all these three objects off camera, so you can give them any name you want, and I'll see you guys in the next video.